Oh, I would cinch up the middle.
No picture. Like, you can't see me?
Okay, got it. We're doing a fold-up granny pouch. Market bag. It folds into a granny pouch. Good. I'm going to start with the chain two method. And this is the granny square that I picked. It's an African flower granny square. And if you go to my profile up there and click on my link tree, I do have a link to the pattern for this granny square in my profile. I'm going to start with, instead of starting with a magic ring, I'm going to start with my chain two method. But for this, this flower actually starts with double crochets. So I'm going to want to use my first chain is where I'm going to work my doubles into. And to do my first double, I'm going to chain one, two, three. So that's actually a chain four. And then in the very first chain, I'm going to work one more double crochet. That's going to count as two double crochets. And then I'm going to chain one. And in the same chain that you did those first two double crochets in, you're going to do two more double crochets. And another chain one. So you want to have eight sets of two double crochets and chain one. So this is one, this is two, and you're putting them all in the same space. So two more double crochets, and your double crochet, these are US standard terms. So I have one, two, three, one, two, three sets of two. This is going to be my fourth set of two. It is going to be tight, so you want to, might want to pull that up a little bit. Double crochet, yarn over, insert my hook into the stitch, yarn over, pull it through. I have three loops on my hook. Yarn over, pull it through two. Yarn over, pull it through two. That's one. Yarn over, insert my hook through my stitch. Yarn over, pull it through the stitch. Yarn over, and pull it through two, and pull it through two. So now I have one, two, three, four sets of one, two, three, four sets of two double crochet with a chain one in between each one. So I'm going to do four more. I'm going to chain one and do two more double crochet. Chain one, do two more double crochet. And one, two, three, six. So now I have total 16 double crochets. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's eight sets of two, which gives me 16 double crochets. And then I am going to chain one, slip stitch the top of that first stitch there. And I'm going to fasten off this color. And to fasten off, I usually just chain two, cut my thread, pull it out, and you can take that chain two and cinch it down, and it'll cinch down to a knot. Now, if you don't like the hole in the center from using that work into the chain method instead of a magic loop, you can take the tail that you left, and you can take your darning needle, and you can weave this thread through those stitches and then pull it tight, and it will pull it tight. The next color I have on here, I used green. So, in any chain one space, I'm going to attach my green yarn. If I have to end this and come back to do the second part of this, it will just be momentarily, and I will actually upload both of them today. So in any chain one space, and I like to pick a different one because I don't like to weave in all my ends at the same spot, so I don't get like a bulge from all my ends being woven in. So I'm going to pick another chain one spot, and I'm just going to slip stitch to join. And I'm going to chain three, and that is going to be my first double crochet. And in that chain one space, I'm going to put two more double crochets. So that's three double crochets into the first chain one space. And then I am going to chain one. I just chained one. I'm going to go to the next chain one space, and I'm going to do three double crochets. And I'm going to do that all the way around. So my three double crochets, chain one, find the next chain one space. So you're going to skip the two double crochets. You're just going to work in the chain one space, and you're going to do three more double crochets. And you're going to work that way all the way around. Three double crochets, chain one. You're going to find the next chain one space. Cindy, thank you for all the likes. All the way around, chain one, and you're going to slip stitch to that first double crochet there, or the first, you know, we chain three, that counts as our double crochet. So that's our second round of our square there. Next round is going to be our third color. So I'm just going to fasten this off, which again, I'm going to just chain two. Cut my thread, pull it through, and cinch down that chain two. Give me one moment. And then I'm going to pick up my third color. And with my third color, And again, I have a link to this pattern that for the flower square that I'm using in my link tree. So if you go to my profile, if I don't get to finish this morning, if you go to my profile, we've got that much done so far. There is a link to this pattern on her blog. It's a blog pattern. So the third one, we're going to do sort of a shell. We're going to do a shell like we did before, two double crochets, and we're going to chain two and then two more double crochets. So in any one of these spaces, any one of those chain spaces, you're going to just join with a slip stitch. So we just joined with a slip stitch, chain three, that counts as our first double crochet, and we're going to double crochet a second time, chain two, and now in the very same space, I'm going to do two more double crochets. So in the same space, I have two double crochets, a chain two, and two double crochets. I am not going to chain between these. I'm just going to chain in the center of those. So I'm going to go directly to the next chain stitch, and I'm going to do two more double crochets. Chain two, and two more double crochets. Can see I have like an open shell, almost like a V stitch on the top of each one of those spaces, and I'm going to do that all the way around. I'm not going to chain in between them. I'm just going to chain my two in at the top of them, so my chain twos are right over top of my chain twos or my chain ones. So I'm just going to, without chaining, go to my next space and do my double crochet twice, chain two, and in the same space, double crochet twice again, and I'm going to do that all the way around. I'm not going to chain, I'm just going to go right to the next space and do two double crochets, a chain one, and two double crochets. To the next space. Whoops, that was supposed to be a chain two. Two double crochets, chain two, two double crochets. So again, in each space, we have two double crochets, chain two, and two double crochets. And by the time we're done, we should have eight sets of those. Always working in eight sets for this flower. So two double crochets, chain two, two double crochets, see ya, go lay down, go lay down, go right to the next one. Two double crochets, chain two, two more double crochets, and I have two more to do. So two more double crochets, chain two, two double crochets, and in the next one, two double crochets, chain two, and two more double crochets, And that was my last one. And now I am just simply going to slip stitch to this first double crochet over here. I am going to not fasten it off because the next row is the same color. So I've slip stitched it to the first chain, the first double crochet. I'm going to slip stitch into the next double crochet. I'm going to slip stitch into the space. So now I'm starting from that space in between there. Cindy, thank you so much for all the lives. Likes. Thank you for all the likes. Now this is just going to be a solid shell of 7 double crochets in each chain 2 space. So to start out, I'm 1, 2, 3 chains. That counts as 1 double crochet, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now I have 1 shell in between in that chain 2 space in my first set of open shells, or V-stitches, however you want to call them. I am not chaining anything. I'm just going to the middle of the next shell, and I'm going to do 7 more. Four, five, six, seven. And I'm going to go all the way around like that. I am not going to chain in between my shells. I'm just going to go to the very next space, and I'm going to do 7 double crochets. The very next space, do 7 double crochets all the way around till I get to the last one. And when I get to the last one and I do my 7 double crochets, I am then just going to slip stitch to that first stitch. So I'm just going to work my way around. That's another 7. And I'm just working my way around. 7 in the next. Go right to the next space in the top of the next shell and do another 7. I really like the square. It's going to end up being a bigger square than I usually make for my tote bags. But I think I might make just a big tote bag out of it anyway. I mean, after I do this project, I might use this. I like this square. 5, 6, 7. And I have 1 more shell. So I'm going to do my last 7. that's my last 7, and I'm just going to slip stitch to the first. It'll be our starting chain, but we're counting it as our first double crochet, so we're just going to slip stitch to that first one there. And then we are going to fasten this color off. So that's what I have so far. So now the edge around it. Let's see. But this is going to be an easy one. So in the next one, and I'm going to do my yellow again. Changing colors here. I'm going to any double crochet. Any double crochet at all. I'm just going to pick a double crochet. So I'm going to start like in the middle of a shell maybe. And maybe at the beginning of a shell. So I'm going to start at the beginning of a shell. So I personally skipped the first stitch of the shell. And I'm going to join with a single crochet to the second stitch of my shell. So that's actually going to be stitch number 2 for that shell. We'll come back to stitch number 1 on our way back around and join it there. So stitch number 2. We skip stitch number 1. I put it in stitch number 2. So I'm going to do 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Will give me 7 crochets total across. You're basically going to put 1 single crochet in every double crochet. And your single crochet is insert your hook, yarn over and pull it through your stitch, yarn over and pull it through 2, insert your hook, yarn over, pull through your stitch, yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Okay, so now that we're in the center of our shells, so we had a shell here and a shell here, we're in the center. We're going to do the same thing we did with the cat stitch. We're going to extend our stitch. So we're going to come all the way down, not into this one, but into this one. And we're going to yarn over and pull it up and pull through to make a single crochet. I have to pause this. I will have 1.5 later, actually in about 10 minutes. So if I don't come back in 5 minutes after I've paused this, I'm coming right back.